students, now we are going to see the construction of an index number of price from the following data by applying last year's method, past year's method, Bowley's method, Fisher ideal index method, and Marshall Edgeworth method. Here the commodity is given, A, B, C, D is given, commodity is given, and the year 2007 price is given, 2007 quantity is given, 2008 price is given, 2008 quantity is given. So now here 2007 2008, okay, so the earliest year is taken as a current year, and another one is taken as the previous year. So here this is the previous year and this is the current year, and this is the P1, Q1, and this is the P0 and Q0, and the price is given 2, 5, 4, 2, 8, 10, 14, 9, 19, 4, 6, 5, 2, 6, 5, 10, 13. Now we will see the workings. The price quantity, price quantity here 2007 and this is 2008, okay. So this is the previous year and this is the current year. The earlier year is the current year, okay, and this is the previous year. So price, okay, this is P0 and this is the Q0, and now this is P1 and this is the Q1. Commodity is given in the problem, okay, commodity A, B, C and D. The price is also given 2, 5, 4, 2, 8, 10, 14, 19, and this is 4, 6, 5, 2, 6, 5, 10, 13, okay. So this is the problem given, okay. Now we are going to calculate index, okay. Index is a singular, indices is the plural, so we are going to calculate various indices, okay. First up, last year's formula, okay. First one is the last year's formula. Last year's formula. What is the formula? Index P01 is equal to summation P1 Q0 divided by summation P0 Q0 into 100. Okay, into 100. Okay, this is the last year's formula. Okay, now we need a P1 Q0 P0 Q0. Okay, from the information above. Okay, now we will calculate a P0. P1, okay, P1, Q0, P1, Q0, and P0, Q0, P1, Q0, P0, Q0, we will calculate from here, okay, from the information. So, where is the P1? P1 is here, okay, and P1 is here, Q0 is here. So, you multiply this two, okay, you multiply this two, okay, 8 multiplied by 4. 32 and 10 multiplied by 6, 60, 14 multiplied by 5, 70, 19 multiplied by 2, 38, and this is the nothing but summation P1 Q0, okay, the total value, okay, 0, and this is 20. So 200, summation P1 Q0 is equal to 200, and P0 Q0. So P0 is here, P0 is here, okay, P0 is here, Q0 is here, okay, P0 is here, Q0 is here. So 2 into 8, 16, okay, and this is 50, and this is 56, and this is 38, the total, okay. The total is 160, okay. Now substitute the values, okay, you substitute the value here, okay. Summation P1 Q0 is 200, okay, and this is summation P0 Q0, okay, take the value 200 divided by 160 multiplied by 200. Okay, and the result is 125. Okay, last year's method index value is 125. Now we will see Pachia's method. Okay, so here the Pachia's number 2. Pachia's index method. Okay, P not 1 is equal to summation P 1 Q 1 divided by summation P 0 Q 1 multiplied by 100. Okay, you take just remember 1001. Okay, 1001, and this is for 1000. Okay, just remember 1000 for last year's and past year's. You just remember 1101 P1 Q1 divided by P0 Q1. Now we need these two values of P1 Q1 and P0 Q1. We need the values of. Now you take here P1 Q1. Okay, P1 Q1. So P1 is here. Okay, P1 is here. Q1 is here. Okay, P1 is here. Q1 is here. Okay, you multiply these two value, 4 into 6 are 24, 6 into 5 30. Okay, and this is 50, and this is 26 are. Okay, the value is, okay, 130. Okay, this is summation P1 Q1 130. Now we need a P0 and Q1. P0 Q1. So P0 is here, P0 is here, Q1 is here. Okay, P1 is here and Q1 is here. So 2 into 6 12, and 5 into 5 25, and this is 40, and this is 26, and this total is, okay, and this is called a summation P0 Q1. Summation P0 Q1. You take the value, these two value. Now 130 divided by 103 multiplied by 100. Okay, the value is, if you multiply, 126.21. Okay, Pachia's method of index value is 126. Third one is the Bowley's. Okay, Bowley's method. So here the formula is P01 is equal to summation P1 Q0, okay, divided by summation P0 Q0 plus summation P1 Q1 divided by summation P0 Q1. The whole thing is divided by 2 multiplied by 100. Okay, so this is the last year's value and this is the past year's value. Okay, we take the values. So 200 divided by 160 plus, okay, plus, and this value is 130 divided by 103. The whole thing is divided by 2. Okay, and the value is, this value is, you will get a 1.25, and this is 1.262 divided by 2 into 100 into 100. Okay, and this, you take this value, so okay, you take the value, this value will be, okay, now we substitute here, okay, adding this two value, you will get to 2.512 divided by 2 divided by 2 into 100, and the value will be 125.6. okay, P not 1 under Bowley's method, the answer is 125.6. now we will see Fisher ideal index method. Fourth one is the Fisher's ideal index method. Fisher ideal index method. So here P naught 1 is equal to root of summation P1 Q0 divided by summation P0 Q0 multiplied by summation P1 Q1 divided by summation P0 Q1. Okay, root of. Okay, now this is the last year's value and this is the past year's value. Substitute the values here. 200 divided by 160 multiplied by 130 divided by 103. So root of. Okay, so multiplied by 100. Okay, multiplied by 100 and this value. Okay, and this value. So this is 200 divided by 160. Okay, it's a 1.25 multiplied by 1.262. Okay, multiplied by 100 and this value is 1.578 multiplied by 100. Now you take the root for this one, you will get 1.256 multiplied by 100 and the index value is 125.6. Okay, Fisher ideal index, the value is 125.6. Next method, Marshall Edgeworth method. Okay, so here P naught 1 is equal to summation P1 Q0 divided by summation P0 Q0. Okay, multiply by here, that is a plus, you add summation P1 Q1 divided by summation P0 Q1 multiplied by 100. Okay, this is alone last year's, this is the past year's value. Okay, you take the values of 200, okay, divided by 160 plus this is 130 and 103 multiplied by 100. Okay, so 200 plus 130 divided by 330, 160 plus 103, 263 multiplied by 100. The value is 125.48. Okay, the final answer is 330 divided by 263, it comes to 1.2548 multiplied by 100, you will get a 125.48. So in this problem we have seen all the five methods, last year's, past year's, Bowley's method, Fisher ideal index method and Marshall Edgeworth method. Okay, and now we are going to see the reversal test for this problem. Okay, so reversal test, to test the adequacy of an index number, we have to do time reversal test and factor reversal test. If the criteria of a good index number is to be satisfied by the above the test. Okay, now we will see the time reversal test and the factor reversal test. There are two tests which are used to test the adequacy of an index number. The two tests are, one is the time reversal test and another one is the factor reversal test. Okay, here time reversal test and the factor reversal test. So it is an important test for testing the consistency of a good index number. This test maintain the time consistency by working both forward and backward with respect to time. Okay, with respect to time. Symbolically, the relationship should be satisfied, that is P01 multiplied by P10 is equal to 1. Okay, so this is the relationship of time reversal test. Whereas this factor reversal test is another test for testing the consistency of a good index number. The product of a price index number and the quantity index number from the base year to current year should be equal to the true value ratio. This is the ratio between the total of current period and the total period. Symbolically, this is P not 1 multiplied by Q not 1 is equal to summation P1 Q1 divided by summation P0 Q0 summation Q0. Okay, this is the symbolical relationship of factor reversal test term. So here we will see what is P01 and what is P10. Okay, now we'll see P01. P01 is nothing but a summation P1 Q0 divided by summation P0 Q0 multiplied by summation P1 Q1 divided by summation P0 Q1. Okay, so this is the P01. Now P10 P10 is nothing but a take a summation P Q divided by summation P Q summation P Q divided by summation P Q. Okay, just have a close look. Okay, you just see the two value. This is P01, this is the value, and this is P10. If you put 1, now you put here 0. If you 0, then you put 1. If 0, put a 1, 0, 1. If it is 1, put 0. 1, put 0. 0, put 1. 1, here 0. Okay, here you are just reversing the time. Reversing the time. I already told 1 is the current year, 0 is the base year or previous year. In time reversal test, we are just shifting the years. We are shifting the years. Okay. 0, 1 is converted into 1, 0. And the relationship is 1. Now we will see. This you multiply by these two. Okay. What we will get? See here. P01 multiplied by P10 is equal to P01. P01 is this is the value. Take here summation P1 Q0 divided by summation P0 Q0 multiplied by summation P1 Q1 divided by summation P0 Q1. Okay, multiplied by P10. P10 value is here. Okay, this is the P10 value. Take the value here. Summation P0 Q1 divided by summation P1 Q1 multiplied by summation P0 Q0 divided by summation P1 Q0. Okay, whole thing wrote up. So now you see P1 Q0. Okay, denominator and the numerator. Okay, you just check it out. P1 Q0 here, P1 Q0, it will get cancel each other. Okay, and P1 Q1, P1 Q1, okay, it will get cancel each other. Next P0 Q1, P0 Q1, here P0 Q1 get cancel each other. P0 Q0, P0 Q0, it will get cancel. Okay, then what is the answer? Okay, root of 1 is equal to 1. So P01 multiplied by P10 is 1. So time reversal test is satisfied. Now you apply the values here. Okay, you apply the values. So P01 multiplied by P10 is equal to, so from the previous problem, okay, P1 Q0, P0 Q0, last year's values. Okay, so you take the value. So P1 Q0 is 200. Okay, divided by P0 Q0 is 160. Okay, 160. And P1 Q1, P1 Q1 is 130. Okay, P0 Q1 Q1 is 103 multiplied by P0 Q1 is 103 divided by P1 Q1 is 130 multiplied by P0 Q0 is 160 and P1 Q0 is 200. So these are the values we have taken from the previous problem working. So okay, now so here check the denominator and the numerator. 200 200, okay, 103 103, 130 130, 160 160. So root of 1 is equal to 1. Now P01 multiplied by P10 is equal to 1. So from the problem we are testing the consistency that time reversal test is satisfied. Okay, you have to write a time reversal test for the problem is satisfied. Now we will see factor reversal test. Next one is the factor reversal test. Okay, so here factor reversal test is P01 multiplied by Q01 is equal to summation P1 Q1 divided by summation P0 and Q0. Okay, we have to prove this. Okay, in factor reversal test, we have to prove P01 multiplied by Q01 is equal to summation P1 Q1 divided by summation P0 Q0. We have to prove. And P01, what is P01? So P01 is equal to summation P1 Q0 divided by summation P0 Q0. And summation P1 Q1 divided by summation P0 Q1. Okay, this is a P01. It's nothing but a Fisher ideal index. Okay, Fisher ideal index formula. Okay, this is the last piece formula, this is the past years formula. Okay, and Q01 summation. Okay, summation, it's just take the value 10 divided by summation 0 0. Okay, multiplied by summation 1 1 summation 0 1. So here in factor reversal test, now you reverse the factors, instead of a price you put quantity. If it is quantity, you put price here. Okay, so here what you are going to do, so here you have to put a Q1 and this is P. Okay, and this is Q0 and P0, and here you have to put Q1 and P1. So here Q0 and P1. Okay, you are reversing the factor. The factor is the price and the quantity is the factor. Okay, in quantity, that is a Q01, you are reversing the factor, without changing the time. Okay, without changing the time, you are reversing the factor. Now you take the P01 multiplied by Q01 is equal to, okay, take the all the values in the values, summation P1 Q0 divided by summation P0 Q0 multiplied by summation P1 Q1 divided by summation P0 Q1 multiplied by, you take this value, summation Q1 P0 divided by summation Q0 P0 summation Q1 P1 divided by summation Q0 P1. Okay, now you take, see here P1 Q0, summation P1 Q0, here summation Q0 P1. Okay, it will get cancelled, 2 into 4 or 4 into 2 both are same. Okay, 2 into 4 and 4 into 2, both are same. Okay, now P1, Q0, this is Q0, P1, it will get cancelled. Okay, it will get cancelled. Now here Q1, P0, this will get cancelled. Q1, P0, okay, this will get cancelled. And the remaining, these two, okay, these two items are remaining. So summation P1, Q1 whole square divided by summation P0, Q0 whole square. Okay, so this is the remaining value. You take the root, then what will be the final one? Summation P1, Q1 divided by summation P0, Q0. So P01 multiplied by Q01 is proved. Okay, factor result test proved. Okay, now based on the previous problem, we are going to apply factor reversal test. So here this is the previous problem. Okay, in the answer. Okay, now we are going to apply the factor reversal test for this problem. Okay, this is the final answer what we get from the previous problem. Okay, so now we apply the values in factor reversal test. Okay, so factor reversal test value, this is the formula. Okay, now you apply P01 multiplied by Q01 is equal to, okay, so P1 Q0 is 200 and this is 116 multiplied by 130 divided by 103 multiplied by P0 Q1. Okay, this is P0 and Q1, 103 divided by P0 Q0, 160 multiplied by, okay, P1 Q1 is 130, and P1 Q0, okay, P1 Q0 is 200. Okay, now this is will get cancelled. 10, 103 is cancelled. Now 130 square divided by 160 square. Take root, it's 130 divided by 160. It is nothing but summation P1 Q1 divided by summation P0 Q0. Hence, factor reversal test is proved, satisfied.